What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. At no point in your rambling, incoherent response were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought.
From the world-famous Blackbird Studios, it's the RaveX Podcast. And now, RaveX.
And speaking of rambling, incoherent responses, thanks for tuning into the RaveX Podcast, Episode 64, Facebook's Dog. I'm your host, Razor Ramon. And today we're going to be talking about how Facebook conditions you. Good, bad, pros, cons, how they get you to change how you think a little bit and change what you post and how you respond in your thoughts and all of that stuff, all in favor of getting those hot thumbs ups and those hearts and those likes and those loves and all of the appreciation and adoration from your friends and peers on Facebook. And with that being said, kids, you know how I work. Let's dive in. So the reason why this episode is called Facebook's Dog, it's going back to a guy named Ivan Pavlov. He was born in 1848, died in 1936, and he had this experiment he did with his dog, right? You guys might have heard of it, Pavlov's dog. Now what he would do is he would ring a bell, and at first the dog would do nothing, and then he'd ring the bell again, and he'd give the dog a treat, give him some food or something, right? And after a while, not too long, that dog came to realize that every single time that bell rung, he would get a treat. And that's just what happens on Facebook, right? I mean, I see posts. I guess virtue signaling comes to mind, right? You know what the worst post is on Facebook? The absolute worst post that makes me want to throw my phone across the room? When someone talks about how much they love their husband or their wife. It's the worst, right? Because here's the thing. Your wife or your husband is probably 15 feet away from you in the next room. But you have to get on Facebook and go, It was 12 years ago today that I met my wife at a Starbucks in Poughkeepsie, New Jersey. And since then, we bought a house, and we now have two beautiful kids and two cars. I just want my wife to know that. Okay, look. I get it. You love your wife. Why not just go tell your wife, man? Why do you gotta get on Facebook, let everyone know how much you love your wife or your husband? I'll tell you why. Because when you put up that type of sappy, emotional, I love my wife, you know for a fact that you're going to get like 47 thumbs up, 23 hearts, the little caring icon. You're going to get all that stuff. And then you check your phone 15 minutes later and you feel like you've done something good, right? Did I say dumb something? You feel like you've done something good. And we all kind of want that, man. We want to know that we're doing something good or that we've done something good. Just like Pavlov's dog. When that bell rings, we want a treat. But for us, it's not a bell. It's all the thumbs up and stuff like I've talked about, right? And that's our little treat, man. It's all of our friends, half of which we've never even met before in real life, who are telling you that, hey, man, you did something good. You're a good person, man, because you love your wife. Spoiler alert, you're supposed to love your wife or you shouldn't have married her. Or your husband, I don't judge, you guys know me. The other post I hate since we're on the topic, the healthy food post. I see so many of these on my feed, right? Somebody goes to the healthy food place, they get a bowl of some tofu, whatever, vegan, whatever, and then they put it on Facebook. It's just a bowl of food that probably tastes horrible, but they're like, I just went to the healthy food place and got the healthy food. And that will get far more thumbs up and all that stuff. My thing is this. Facebook is great for keeping in touch with people. If you got a podcast, you want to promote it, you got a band, you're an artist, you want to promote your artwork, it's great, you know, keep in touch with your friends, all that stuff. All the stupid virtual signaling, man, just stop it. It's sad. People are like begging for thumbs up and appreciation because they all want a little pat on their head to be told they're a good person. Great. You went to the healthy food place, right? Or it's like the I voted. Every time we get next to an election or an election time, all you see is, I voted, all these I voted stickers. I get it, you voted. Guess what? You're supposed to vote. I don't vote because I'm a horrible person. But aside from that, you're kind of supposed to vote. You're supposed to kind of eat healthy. You're supposed to love your kids and your wife. Why is it that these people need the appreciation of essentially complete and total strangers to make them feel like they did the right thing, man? I'll tell you why. Because we're all a little unsure of ourselves, right? We're all not really sure what we're supposed to be doing, man. Society today, we're like a rudderless ship. And unfortunately, we found some of that guidance in Facebook. We post something we know is going to get a lot of positive attention, and that's our little treat, man. And you know, I'm not going to say stop, because I don't like telling anyone what they should do. But let's try to reel it in a little bit. And I got a couple of examples here of things that happened to me on Facebook, which really made me decide, maybe I don't want a Facebook anymore. But I got a podcast and a band, and I got to promote that stuff, so I guess I'll keep it. I had a situation with a friend, man. He put up a picture, and it was a tasteless picture. It wasn't his fault, but he put up a picture of two women wearing a shirt that said, "Thank God for abortion," or something like that. And then he said, "Tell me how you feel about this. Give me your opinion." So I gave him my opinion. It's just two crazy dumb broads wearing a shirt with a pretty disgusting slogan across the front. And then I went on to say, who gives a shit? It's a picture. You're never going to meet these people in your life. And if this picture really offends you, then don't look at the picture. And I think I gave the example of, if someone showed me a picture of a white guy wearing a shirt that said, "I hate N-words," I'm not going to get bent out of shape over it. It's just a picture. Hit delete, cut your phone off, whatever. But on Facebook and social media, we kind of think that's not an option, right? Not only that, but we sort of go looking for stuff to be offended by, and then we post it because we hope that everyone else is just as offended as we are. Look, I heard something, right? Someone said, "I try not to offend people, and I try even harder to not be offended." And that's my view on it. Sure, it was tasteless. Two women wearing shirts that said, "God bless abortion," or "Thank God for abortion," and I think they were holding a baby. Yeah, offensive, gruesome, horrible. And this is what we do on Facebook, man. We ask for someone's opinion, we get someone's opinion, and then we get mad at them, and we unfollow them or we block them. Now, don't get me wrong. I've seen some pretty ridiculous kind of racist shit on Facebook, and I've blocked people and unfollowed them. That was extreme situations, man. If I see something, I just disagree with it, I just go on about my effing day. It reminds me of what Charles Barkley once said. Somebody asked Charles Barkley, basketball player, how he felt about these statues of, Confederate generals and these people, and this guy owned slaves. Charles Barkley said, "Man, I ain't paying attention to no statue. I'm trying to pay my bills, pay my mortgage, take care of my kids. You think I'm gonna walk past a statue and let that ruin my day? Come on now." And I feel the same exact way. But the way Facebook has conditioned us, if you've got, let's say, 500 friends on your page, you need to agree with what they agree with, or you're not gonna get those thumbs up and those hearts and those likes. And if they're offended and disgusted by something, you too need to be offended and disgusted by it, or else they're just not gonna comment on your post, and you don't get that little treat after hearing that bell. It's crazy, right? Somebody on my friend list put up a post about Felicity Huffman and Tanya McDowell. Now, if you don't know who Tanya McDowell is, she was a black woman who got 5 years in jail for lying on a form that said where her and her child lived, so that her kid could go to a better school. And the comparison was Felicity Huffman bribed someone and got zero jail time, and this black woman just said she lived in this district as opposed to that district so that her kid could go to a better school, and she got 5 years in jail. Now, I was looking at this post, and everyone was commenting on how horrible it was and all the angry faces. And so I looked at it because I'm a smart person, and I said, okay, this can't be what it is. There's got to be more to this. So I researched it. Tanya McDowell has a criminal record half a mile long. She had a gun with no permit. She had robbed a place. There was something in there about bank robbery. She was selling drugs out of her house. And she was convicted or charged with prostitution. So her lying on a form so that her kid could go to a better school was one of like five other really serious things, man. And honestly, the fact that she only got 5 years kind of shows that the criminal justice system, which has always been kind of corrupt if you're a minority, I'm not gonna dispute that, of course. I've had trouble with the law and I ain't never done shit, man. But when you look into the Tanya McDowell case, point is, she did a lot of bad things that are illegal, against the law, and some of them were felonies. But you just put up a picture of a white woman on the left, picture of a black woman on the right and you say, both these women did the same thing, or the white woman, what she did was worse, but the black woman got 5 years. Things like that are horrible because it feeds the sort of fire of racism, and we don't need that anymore. We don't need anyone to fuel the fires of racism. We've got plenty of stuff for that. After I Googled it and I researched it for about 20 minutes, made sure I had my facts straight, I went back and I posted under that picture to my friend who was on Facebook, and I said, hey, look, this isn't even an apples and apples comparison, man. This is like apples and lettuce. This is 100% different. And I just cited the facts. Tanya McDowell had a past of committing crimes, bad crimes. Felicity Huffman, although what she did was incredibly douchey, she did not have a past of any crimes. Violent crimes, misdemeanors, felonies. And the way the court system works, if it's not a violent crime and you don't have anything in your past, you can kind of plead that down to just like probation. That's how the legal system works. But when this person posted this picture, they just want you to get angry and say, hey, Whitey, what's up with you? This is horrible. Look at how horrible. And I'm so sick of the look at how horrible our country is post. And I'm sick of the things that aren't really racism. I hear a lot of people on Facebook talking about equality. All we want is equality. And you know what? Nobody who claims to want equality actually wants it. What they want is the deck tilted in their favor so that they can do whatever they want and you can't say shit about it. The whole thing is this weird social media construct to get you to think the way that other people want you to think. I mean, look, if you're a Red Sox fan and the Red Sox lose and someone posts, Yankees beat the Red Sox, I knew it was going to happen, Yankees are the best. You can't dispute that, right? You can't dispute it. But if someone posts something that says the racist Yankees and their racist umpires beat the Red Sox, but the whole thing was a sham, you are going to get stupid people who see that post, and they might believe you. And all you've done is you've kind of turned someone who's not racist into a racist, because now they hate a particular baseball team or the umpire or whatever, because you made it seem like race was a factor as to why the Red Sox lost. These posts are so horrible. They're so detrimental to people's minds. And it's, look, just quit it. Now look, kids, your boy Ravex ain't perfect, and I made a mistake the other day. I put a political post on Facebook, and boy, was I sorry that I did this, man, because people, look, I don't get overly serious about politics. I'm not too interested in the sort of presidential thing. I'm more interested in local politics because that affects you the most. But I was talking about Donald Trump, Kamala Harris, Joe Biden, and my question was this, and it was a fair question. Are people excited about Biden-Harris? Or do they just hate Donald Trump? Because there is a difference. You know, the second Joe Biden said, Kamala Harris is my running mate, all of the Harris-Biden things started going up on Facebook. And it's like, fine, whatever, do it. I don't care. But do you love Joe Biden and Kamala Harris? Or do you hate Donald Trump? I just want to know, man. Right? I don't like any of them. I don't like Joe Biden with his stupid comments about, if you don't vote for me, you're not black. Fuck you, Joe Biden. Fuck you and suck my black... Really, Joe Biden? You're going to dictate to black people? Look, forget, I'm not going to get into it. Kamala Harris, I don't like her at all. I can't even get into it because I'll get the hate mail. Whatever. I like Cory Booker and Tulsi Gabbard. To each their own, man. Do what you're going to do. But it was interesting how many people went under that post that I put up and were commenting, like, serious, like, hey, man, you know, you better vote for, you know, Joe Biden. And I said, I'm going to write in Steve Rogers and King T'Challa. Now, if you don't know who that is, King T'Challa is Black Panther, and Steve Rogers is Captain America. And someone chimed in, well, you know, a vote for Captain America is a vote for Donald Trump, and he's not on the ballot, and blah, blah. Okay, I was joking. You think I'm really gonna vote for Captain America? It was a joke. Can we joke on Facebook anymore? Apparently not. And people really were like, don't waste your vote. I can't take 4 more years of this guy. You know what? You know why Donald Trump doesn't bother me? Because I don't listen to anything he says. If he's on TV, I cut the TV off. If he's on the radio, I hit mute. I don't care. Look, I heard someone say that if you could somehow block out news or media of who the president was and you didn't know who won the election, you probably wouldn't even know that Joe Blow or Steve Taylor or whoever was the president. You wouldn't even know. The president deals with a lot of foreign shit, Of course, he does domestic shit, but the president's kind of ceremonial, right? I liked Barack Obama because Obama made everyone feel like everything was going to be okay. When he would show up for his weekly press and he'd go, "Hello, everybody. I'm Barack Obama. Today, we just signed a law." It was just like, okay, cool. He just seemed like a cool dude, and I felt like everything was going to be cool in a gang, baby. I don't know about his policies, whatever. I will never get political on Facebook again because you can't even make a joke. People hate Trump so much. That Trump derangement syndrome is real. People hate Trump so much that if you say, "I disagree with 99% of what Trump did, except for that one thing, I thought that was a good move," they will turn on you and the feeding frenzy will begin, and they will never comment on your post. They will never thumbs up on your post because you said you like one thing that a president did. It is absolutely insane. People, please get a grip. Just keep living your life, man, and doing the best that you can do. So my original point was this. People will post stuff, their opinion, and you have to agree with it, or you get wished out into the cornfield. So what you see is just stupid people encouraging more and stupid people to be stupid, right? If that makes any sense. Because people will go along with these things because they want the thumbs up, they want the likes, just like I said. And I'll tell you something, man. The other horrible post that I really can't stand is when a woman who, look, she can be attractive, not very attractive, whatever, you fill that in for yourself. But what a woman will do is she'll take a picture of herself, and it's not a great picture. Not that she's unattractive, but she'll take a picture like from the dashboard of her car with light coming in from one side, and the camera's facing up her nose, and her eyes are bloodshot, and you can see her nose hairs. And you know what happens? You're going to get 63 other women who go, "Oh, Karen, beautiful picture, looking so good, looking hot, sexy, oh my God, you're so fierce, thumbs up." Here's why they do that. They know it's a bad picture, and they know that that woman doesn't particularly look good, or the guy, I don't judge, doesn't look good in that picture. The reason why they hit the thumbs up and tell her how beautiful they are is because they're hoping that when they put up a stupid picture of theirself in the grocery store with that horrible, harsh grocery store lighting, and like one of the eyes is open more than the other, and her hair's all messed up, and she's got a little piece of spinach in her teeth, she knows that everyone else is going to say, "Oh, Catherine, great picture. You look so beautiful." And that's all, that's what we do. I mean, look, I'm a musician. I put songs on Facebook. People tell me, "Hey, great song." I know it's a great song, and I knock it out of the park every single time. I don't put bad songs on Facebook hoping that people say, "Hey, man, great tune," just to make me feel better about myself. You know what I do? I get in the studio, I practice my bass lines, and I hit it out of the goddamn park. So if you want some type of appreciation, get it from yourself, man. Let yourself be the person who boosts you up and gives you all the appreciation you need. Don't get it from thumbs up and likes when you know you're full of shit. Because half the time you know you're full of shit. But you're counting on the other 1,500 people out there who are also full of shit who want to be encouraged and supported. So it's like a stupid, retarded snake biting its own stupid, retarded tail. And that snake's name is Facebook. Well, that's going to wrap it up for me, kids. I got shit to do. Do me a favor. Check out an episode I did before this one, episode 63, My Mind is Playing Tricks on Me, man. It's only available through Bandcamp, ravexmusic.bandcamp.com. It's a Bandcamp exclusive. And while you're there on the Bandcamp site, look on the right-hand side and hit follow. That's right. Now, here's the irony. Click like, subscribe, do all that good stuff, man, so we can keep this show going and keep the truth going. My name's RaveX, kids. Do me a favor, remember this. The vision is only as good as the execution. My name's RaveX. Enjoy yourself.
That was the RaveX Podcast. Be sure to click like and subscribe. For podcasts, new music, and all things RaveX, go to youtube.com and search RaveX Music.